Chronic pain is a big deal. Depending on where you live, it affects anywhere from 10% to more than 45% of the population. Why and where is this happening? And how did it get so bad? First, let's define chronic pain. Chronic, aka persistent pain, is any pain that lasts more than 3 months. For many people, pain can last years and even decades despite the original injury having healed. Common chronic pain conditions include ailments such as back pain, repetitive strain injury, and other joint pain. Strangely enough, you don't have to be injured to feel pain or develop chronic pain. Conditions such as migraines, sciatica, and fibromyalgia often occur without any injury and can be debilitating. Before we get into the facts and figures of chronic pain, let's touch on the diagnosis of chronic pain, which is the key to understanding why billions of people around the world are still suffering. Persistent pain can be caused by either an ongoing physical injury or structural issue, such as a broken bone, nerve damage, tumor, infection, or cancer, or brain-induced pain. This is also known as neural pathway pain. Pain science research has shown that the brain can continue creating pain even after an injury has healed, or, as mentioned earlier, even without any injury being present. Thoughts, feelings, and situations can be enough to create pain, and the longer we experience pain, the better our pain system gets at creating pain again. Why does this happen? Acute pain from an injury may have lasted long enough for your brain to develop a habit of creating pain. Or, the pain could be a result of underlying stress and anxiety that is not being addressed. It can even be a combination of these two factors. Pain is a protective mechanism. It's there to protect us from certain harmful actions and to alert us that something might be wrong with our body. But as with any of our body's protective mechanisms, it can become overprotective and oversensitive, as is often the case when pain becomes chronic and outlasts the normal healing time period. With the exception of infections, tumors, and cancer, we know that most medical professionals are incorrectly labeling the vast majority of chronic pain as a physical injury or structural issue, as opposed to neural pathway pain. When this happens, the consequences are nothing short of dire. Believing something is broken inside of them, patients become afraid to move and afraid of pain. This fear and anxiety keeps patients locked in a cycle of pain and fear. Medications and operations will offer little relief, if any. Patients end up believing they have no other option but to live with the pain, and they often develop an array of complex coping strategies that interfere with living a normal and happy life. But how do we know that most patients with chronic pain don't have a structural issue or injury? First, let's consider the likelihood of a structural issue or injury that lasts more than 6 months. The UK's National Health Service states that a severe broken leg will heal on its own within 4 to 6 months. A severe slipped disc will heal on its own within 3 months. The human body has a remarkable ability to heal, but it's also just as easy for your brain to develop habits, such as continuing to create pain after an injury has healed, or creating pain due to perceived triggers, worry, and negative expectations. Furthermore, clinical imaging such as MRIs and CT scans can sometimes do more harm than good. These imaging techniques became widely available in the early 1980s. Unfortunately, rather than help cure persistent pain, patients and doctors saw what they thought was damage on a scan, and this led to fear and high expectations of pain. Surgical procedures to fix what was thought to be a problem rarely worked and often made the pain worse. Significant research shows that even trained experts cannot tell the cause of pain just by looking at a scan. For example, a 2015 study in the American Journal of Neuroradiology found that MRIs of pain-free 30-year-olds showed degenerative disc disease in 50% of patients and bulging discs in 40% of patients. Those statistics reached levels of 80% and 60%, respectively, in pain-free 50-year-olds, and are even higher in older patients. The vast majority of adults, therefore, have abnormal MRIs, proving that these abnormalities do not necessarily cause pain. Despite this, many clinicians continue to point to minor structural findings as the cause of chronic neck, back, and other pain. Industry-leading pain specialists such as Alan Gordon, the executive director of the Pain Psychology Center in Los Angeles, and Howard Schubiner, director of mind-body medicine at Providence Park Hospital, estimate that 70 to 90% of people that suffer from chronic pain do so because of neural pathway pain, not something wrong in the body, but the brain continuing to create pain due to pain sensitization. Let's just think about that for a moment. A market research report by global industry analysts indicates that more than 1.5 billion people worldwide suffer from chronic pain. That means around 1.2 billion people suffer from chronic pain without anything being mechanically wrong with their body. The vast majority of these people are completely unaware that the pain is neural pathway pain, an irrational or learned behavior by the brain, and that the brain can be retrained to stop creating this pain, that they could live a pain-free life. Thousands of patient reports and independent research supports our ability to retrain the brain to stop chronic pain. For example, 2017 research by the University of Utah, published in the Journal of Internal Medicine, concluded, after participating in a single 15-minute session of certain mind-body therapies, patients reported an immediate decrease in pain levels, similar to what one might expect from an opioid painkiller. Most medical practices still consider pain as a symptom of a disease or structural issue, whereas it needs to be thought of as a problem in itself. For the estimated 1.2 billion people that suffer from neural pathway pain, pills and operations will offer little relief or simply worsen symptoms. Continuing with our back pain example, numerous studies point to the low success rate of back surgeries, but they are still being conducted in record numbers. Medical website Health Outcome collected 23,320 patient reviews on various back surgeries. Results showed that 83% of the patients are still in pain years after surgery, 14% were still recovering, and only 3% of people operated on had a reduction in pain. As for painkillers, in the US, the highly publicized opioid epidemic claims more than 100 lives every single day. How and why can this still be happening? Why don't more patients and doctors realize that the vast majority of chronic pain is neural pathway pain? Well, many reasons. First, treating chronic pain requires effort from the patient. They need to objectively assess pain-creating behaviors and emotions and learn new techniques to break out of the pain cycle. In addition, most patients are accustomed to seeing a doctor for 15 minutes, being prescribed something, and hoping that it works. We live in a pill culture with expectations of instant relief. Also, most general medical professionals simply aren't trained to treat chronic pain, and even if they are, it's difficult to do so with the time they have with each patient. Explaining to a patient that their pain is 100% real, but their brain is creating that pain unnecessarily, can be a sensitive topic. Some patients are aware of conditions such as phantom limb pain, where a person will feel completely real pain in a limb that isn't there. But many are completely unaware unless given a thorough explanation on pain science, which often just isn't practical for the doctor. Unfortunately, financial incentives also play a big part in this. In the US alone, the back pain industry is worth more than $100 billion. That's a lot of medical professionals getting paid for unnecessary painkillers, injections, surgeries, physio, and medical devices. We know that chronic pain affects billions of people around the world, but what does it look like in your country? Statistics haven't been published for every country, but for those where there is reputable research, here are the top six in order of number of people affected. In China, 501 million people are living with chronic pain. India is second, with 174 million people affected. In the USA, it's between 100 and 116 million people. 77 million people affected in Brazil. 28 million people affected in the UK. 20 million people affected in France. And here are some more stats for those countries not included in that list. There's a lot to take in, so you might want to pause the video or take a look at this graphic on our blog. The link is in the description. Chronic pain is by far the biggest global health burden. This must and can change. Chronic pain affects not only individuals like you and I, it also affects families, the healthcare system, and society as a whole. If you suffer from chronic pain, be sure to always get more than one medical opinion. And most importantly, have hope. You don't need to live in pain. This video is brought to you by Pathways, the chronic pain therapy app. Our mission is to free at least 1 million people from chronic pain. If we're able to reach that goal, we think we can really start to make a difference in the way persistent pain is treated around the world. If you suffer from chronic pain, you can download our app for free, and we'll do our best to retrain your brain so you can overcome pain. Or if you know someone with persistent pain, share this video. It might just change their life.